Welcome to This Week at Minnesota.
The U has a long history of STEM education, and with professors like Christy Haynes, the future continues to look bright. Haynes and her graduate students have discovered a way to measure chemicals being released by blood platelets in real time. This breakthrough could lead to new treatments to stop and prevent blood clotting. This research earned Haynes a selection as one of Popular Science magazine's Brilliant 10.
It's humbling to be labeled with an adjective like that, but I think it's really great because I think the University of Minnesota is generally underrated. I think we have an astounding set of people and facilities here that I think the humble nature of the Midwesterner doesn't always toot their own horn very well, and so it's nice to get press in that kind of media.
Science and technology were the topics during a wide-ranging lecture by New York Times tech writer and Nova Science Now host David Pogue. Speaking to students in CSE 1000, Pogue detailed how technology is changing the world. Pogue believes there's a science problem in the United States and says that's why STEM education is so critical.
Science and engineering are the skills for innovation, and innovation is what we need for success in business and in the world. So if we want the economy to revive, it's about innovation. It's about science and tech. I mean, what's the biggest company in the world? Apple. It's a technology company.
At Minnesota, we're also the leading institution on the North Star STEM Alliance, and our STEM Education Center continues to prepare teachers in all four areas of STEM. That's This Week at Minnesota. Connect with us on Twitter and let us know what you'd like to see in upcoming editions of This Week.